Hello everyone, this is Science Vines and you're watching the audiovisual chapter of class 11th biology. This is the first part of chapter 19, excretory products and their elimination. Animals accumulate ammonia, urea, uric acid, carbon dioxide, water and ions like Na+, K+, Cl-, phosphate, sulfate, etc. either by metabolic activities or by other means like excess ingestion. These substances have to be removed totally or partially. In this chapter, you will learn the mechanisms of elimination of these substances with special emphasis on common nitrogenous waste. Ammonia, urea, and uric acid are the major forms of nitrogenous waste excreted by the animals. Ammonia is the most toxic form and requires large amount of water for its elimination, whereas uric acid, being the least toxic, can be removed with a minimum loss of water. The process of excreting ammonia is ammonotelism. Many bony fishes, aquatic amphibians, and aquatic insects are ammonotelic in nature. Ammonia, as it is readily soluble, is generally excreted by diffusion across body surfaces or through gill surfaces in fish as ammonium ions. Kidneys do not play any significant role in its removal. Terrestrial adaptation necessitated the production of lesser toxic nitrogenous waste like urea and uric acid for conservation of water. Mammals, many terrestrial amphibians and marine fishes mainly excrete urea and are called ureotelic animals. Ammonia produced by the metabolism is converted into urea in the liver of these animals and released into blood, which is filtered and excreted by the kidneys. Some amount of urea may be retained in the kidney matrix of some of these animals to maintain desired osmolarity. Reptiles, birds, land snails and insects excrete nitrogenous waste as uric acid in the form of pellet or paste with a minimum loss of water are called uricotelic animals. A survey of animal kingdom presents a variety of excretory structure. In most of the invertebrates, these structures are simple tubular forms, whereas vertebrates have complex tubular organs called kidneys. Some of these structures are mentioned here. Protonephridia or flame cells are the excretory structures in platyhelminths, flatworms, example planaria, rotifers, some annelids and the cephalochordate. Amphioxus. Protonephridia are primarily concerned with ionic and fluid volume regulation, that is osmoregulation. Nephridia are the tubular excretory structures of earthworm and other annelids. Nephridia help to remove nitrogenous waste and maintain a fluid and ionic balance. Malpighian tubules are the excretory structures of most of the insects, including cockroaches. Malpighian tubules help in the removal of nitrogenous waste and osmoregulation. Antennal glands or green glands perform the excretory function in crustaceans like prawns. Now the human excretory system. In humans, the excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, one pair of ureters, a urinary bladder and a urethra. Figure 19.1. Kidneys are reddish brown, bean shaped structures situated between the levels of last thoracic and third lumbar vertebrae, close to the dorsal inner wall of the abdominal cavity. Each kidney of an adult human measures 10 to 12 cm in length, 5 to 7 cm in width, 2 to 3 cm in thickness, with an average weight of 120 to 170 gram. Towards the center of the inner concave surface of the kidney is a notch called hilum, through which ureter, blood vessels and nerve enters. Inner to the hilum is a broad funnel shaped space called the renal pelvis with projection called calyces. The outer layer of kidney is a tough capsule. Inside the kidney there are two zones, an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The medulla is divided into a few conical masses or medullary pyramids projecting into the calyces, singular calyx. The cortex extends in between the medullary pyramids as renal columns called columns of Burtini. figure 19.2 is a longitudinal section of a kidney. Each kidney has nearly 1 million complex tubular structures called nephrons, which are the functional units. Each nephron has two parts, the glomerulus and the renal tubule. Glomerulus is a tuft of capillaries formed by the afferent arteriole, a fine branch of renal artery. Blood from the glomerulus is carried away by an efferent arteriole. The renal tubule begins with a double-walled cup-like structure called Bowman's capsule, which encloses the glomerulus. Glomerulus, along with the Bowman's capsule, is called the Malpighian body or renal corpuscle. The tubule continues further to form a highly coiled network, proximal convoluted tubule. PCT, a hairpin-shaped Henle's loop in the next part of the tubule, which has a descending and ascending limb. The ascending limb continues as another highly coiled tubular region called distal convoluted tubule or DCT. The DCTs of many nephrons open into a straight tube called collecting duct, many of which converge and open into the renal pelvis through medullary pyramids into the calyces. The Malpighian corpuscle, PCT and DCT of the nephron are situated in the cortical region of the kidney, whereas the loop of Henle dips into the medulla. In majority of nephrons, the loop of Henle is too short and extends over only very little into the medulla. Such nephrons are called cortical nephrons. In some of the nephrons, the loop of Henle is very long and runs deep into the medulla. These nephrons are called juxtamedullary nephrons. The efferent arteriole emerging from the glomerulus forms a fine capillary network and around the renal tubule called the peritubular capillaries. A minute vessel of this network runs parallel to the Henle's loop, forming a U-shaped vasa recta. Vasa recta is absent or highly reduced in cortical nephrons. Urine formation. Urine formation involves three main processes, namely glomerular filtration, reabsorption and secretion, that take place in different parts of the nephron. The first step in urine formation is the filtration of blood, which is carried out by the glomerulus and is called glomerular filtration. On an average, 1100 to 1200 ml of blood is filtered by the kidneys per minute, which constitute roughly 1/5 of the blood pumped out of each ventricle of the heart in a minute. The glomerular capillary blood pressure causes filtration of blood through three layers, that is the endothelium of glomerular blood vessel, the epithelium of Bowman capsule, and a basement membrane between these two layers. The epithelial cells of Bowman's capsule called podocytes are arranged in an intricate manner so as to leave some minute spaces called filtration slits or slit pores. Blood is filtered so finely through these membranes that almost all the constituents of the plasma except the proteins pass onto the lumen of Bowman's capsule. Therefore, it is considered as a process of ultrafiltration. The amount of filtrate formed by the kidney per minute is called glomerular filtration rate or GFR. GFR in a healthy individual is approximately 125 ml per minute, that is 180 liters per day. The kidneys have built-in mechanisms for the regulation of glomerular filtration rate. One such efficient mechanism is carried out by the juxta glomerular apparatus. JGA is a special sensitive region formed by the cellular modifications in the distal convoluted tubule and the afferent arteriole at the location of their contact. A fall in GFR can activate the JG cell to release renin, which can stimulate the glomerular blood flow and thereby the GFR back to normal. A comparison of the volume of the filtrate formed per day, 180 liter per day, with that of the urine released 1.5 liters suggests that nearly 99% of the filtrate has to be reabsorbed by the renal tubules. This process is called reabsorption. The tubular epithelial cells in different segments of the nephron perform this either by active or a passive mechanisms. For example, substances like glucose, amino acids, sodium, etc. in the filtrate are reabsorbed actively, whereas the nitrogenous waste are absorbed by passive transport. Reabsorption of water also occurs passively in the initial segments of the nephron. During urine formation, the tubular cells secrete like H plus, K plus and ammonia into the filtrate. The tubular secretion is also an important step in urine formation, as it helps in the maintenance of ionic and acid-base balance of the body fluids. Here we end the first part of the chapter 19, excretory products and their elimination. To watch more such videos, do subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so you don't miss any video. And if you want us to create more such videos on any other book or subject, do mention in the comment section please. Like and share the video to keep us motivated to create such content. Thank you for watching the video. Bye bye. Love.